Okay, the title of my talk is Analysis of Flow Structural Elements Around Obstacles in Thermodynamically Non-Equilibrium Media. As thermodynamically non-equilibrium media, we consider a stratified fluid, which is known to have a diffusion molecular flux, which always exists in the direction opposite to external force action. It's obvious that there is no homogeneous fluid in the natural systems, and each fluid is less or more non-homogeneous to presence of different dissolved substances, suspended particles, non-uniformity of temperature distribution, pressure, and so on. And under action of, and we always live in the under action of different external forces such as gravitational, centrifugal or electromagnetic forces, and under action of these external forces, we a stratification is formed, in such a stratified fluid, there can exist even fluid motions even in absence of pure mechanical reasons. So we have a motionless obstacle and. There can exist some fluid motions around these obstacles even without any mechanical reasons. So the main goal of our presentation is to classify different flow regimes starting from the low speed diffusion induced flows which are formed by molecular flux breaking on the obstacles, and to more complex transient multiscale vortex flow regime, which are accompanied by complex interaction of large and fine scale components between each other and with the free stream. So method of analysis is main method of analysis is numerical simulation, and also we compare our results with analytical and laboratory data. So some illustration. So we have a non-homogeneous fluid, and under action of as an external force, we consider gravity. Under action of gravity, we have redistribution of dissolved substances in the vertical direction, and formation of a stable stratification. And in this fluid, a molecular diffusion flux exists, which directed in this particular case from down to up in the direction opposite to gravity force action. And if we set impermeable obstacle in such a fluid, it breaks the diffusion molecular diffusion flux that leads to formation of zones of concentration excess and deficiency of a stratifying agent, and formation of compensatory fluid motions, which are called diffusion-induced flows. This is an illustration of diffusion-induced flows. So we have infinite slope, and the fluid is going not down but up the hill. There is some analytical evaluation, but these evaluations are virtually one-dimensional. So we have infinite slope, and these formulas are calculated only dependent on only one coordinate, normal to the wall. But in reality, we understand that there is no infinite bodies. We must consider finite dimensions of bodies. So to take into account finite dimensions of the obstacle, we must apply numerical simulation. And this some illustration what the diffusion induced flows. Here the smoke, you see the smoke from the factory chimneys which is going in the opposite direction up the hills, and there is a temperature stratified atmosphere in the evening when the ground is hotter than the surrounding air. And this is facility of Schlieren instrument in the Laboratory of Fluid Mechanics, Institute for Problems in Mechanics, which using which we can visualize diffusion loose flows and internal waves around obstacles. So let's go to problem formulation. We have an inclined plate with a certain length and thickness, and it moves or from right to left at a certain speed, or as analogous formulation, we have a free stream which is flow the plate. So the Gowan equation, we consider the equation of state, incompressibility equation, Navier-Stokes equation with accounting for the gravity in Boussinesq approximation, and diffusion equation. As a boundary condition, we consider no slip and no flux boundary conditions for velocity and salinity. And as initial condition, we consider the fields of diffusion-induced flows. So when we consider the movement of the plate, the initial state is a diffusion-induced flows, which is formed on the immovable, motionless obstacle. We use for our analysis direct numerical simulation. Initially, we developed our own programs in using programming language Fortran, but later we find very good package which allows to access to source code, and we can change implement our own solvers, our own programs inside this package for our particular needs. Our particular needs in this case is to account stratification and diffusion effects. Typical scales of the problem, it's time scale, buoyancy period, length scales, it's length and thickness of the plate, and attached internal waves, and viscous and diffusion micro scales. And our main goal is classification into fluid types and flow regimes. So we consider four basic fluid types. A strongly stratified fluid, which is typical for laboratory experiments. So such a strong stratification usually used in stratified tanks, brine, salt solutions. A weakly stratified, it's typical for ocean and sea media, and potentially homogeneous fluid. So as I said before, there is no homogeneous fluid. Each fluid is less or more is homogeneous. So it's a real situation for pure water. So because there always exists some non-homogeneity. And actual homogeneous fluid, it's mathematical abstraction. So it's without taking account stratification and diffusion effects, because in reality, non-homogeneity is always present. And we also classified flow regimes. Diffusion-induced flows, which are the slowest one on the motionless obstacles. Extra slow regime very slow speed of movement of the obstacle. Wave regime, when internal waves appear, upstream perturbations and attached internal waves. Vortex regime, when the intensive vortices appear in the wake and around the obstacles. And non-stationary regimes with relatively high Reynolds number, which is the most complicated from this. So we begin our classification from diffusion-induced flows. It's a schematic representation, so we consider different forms of the obstacle, inclined plate, cylinder, wedge-shaped obstacle, and there is a typical velocity profile with the main jet which is going along this surface of an obstacle, and compensatory backflow. This results in numerical results for diffusion-induced flows around a sloping plate. So, in case of a horizontal plate, we see here you see the streamlines, and green color correspond to cyclonic rotation in circulating cells, and the blue color to correspond to anticyclonic rotation. And we see the structure is symmetric around the obstacles with a multiple level of circulation cells. But even a small deviation from the horizontal position, we see that the symmetry is broken and a single circulation cell is formed around the obstacle. And then at angles of inclination about 30 and more degrees, the jet flows around the plate get thinner, and anticyclonic rotation, big anticyclonic rotation circulation cells are formed, which are adjacent to the main jets. There is no main flow. It's diffusion-induced flows. There is no flow caused by diffusion processes, only by diffusion processes. And this is comparison of our results on the sloping plate with the analytics. But as I said before, analytics doesn't work when works for infinite slope, and it doesn't work when the angle or inclination tends to zero. So we have some differences in this area. We see that analytics tends to infinity when the angle tends to zero. So it's a thickness of the jet flow. This is velocity of these jet flows. It's a very interesting situation when we submerge a wedge-shaped obstacle in stratified fluid. In this situation, also we have salinity excess near under the wedge, and salinity deficiency over it. But you see, in the pressure field, you see the intensive and extensive zone of negative pressure. This negative pressure. We have a situation when a wedge is sucked by the this negative zone. So it leads to self motion of a wedge. There are a lot of experimental results which confirm this. Situation that a wedge begin moves horizontally in a stratified medium. Also, such experiments were performed in the Institute for Problems in Mechanics. This is a numerical some simulation using the dynamic mesh. And here you see some comparison of numerical results. Here the numerical results for horizontal plate and for sloping plate. And this is laboratory modeling. So we see that the numerical and experimental results are in a qualitative agreement. We see the prolongated interfaces which are attached to the edges of the plate. The same for the disk and for the cylinder. So also we see these prolongated layer structures which attach to the poles of the cylinder. And what happens when the obstacle begin to move? The structure of the floor changes dramatically, and we see formation of attached internal waves and upstream perturbations. So here some simulation, numerical simulation using dynamic mesh techniques. So it's upstream perturbations, which tends to horizontal, and here some attached internal waves are formed in the wake. This is relatively small velocity or movement, 1 centimeter per second.
Why it's not so symmetrical and vertical? Why?
Right.
Initially symmetrical, but later time it's not symmetrical. It becomes not
symmetrical. Where do you see not
later,
symmetrical?
Later time.
Later time? It's symmetric, but it's a vertical vertical component of velocity.
Oh, like,
where you see non-symmetric? It's everything is symmetric. And you see different for internal wave structure for different velocity of movement. We see that with increase of velocity of movement, the area, the perturbed area increases, and along with increase of length of internal waves. And here you see the synchronized images. Here the numerical simulation, and here the Schlieren visualization. So it shows how. The structure of internal waves change with change of fluid types, with decrease of stratification. Let's go further. And now I would like to show you what happens to show you different flow regimes on the inclined plate. So here you see the diffusion induced flow. There is no flow, no movement, here you see the when the plate begin to move with a extremely slow velocity. Here you see the complex interaction of diffusion induced flow with the internal waves. Here you see the clearly manifested internal waves, which are generated by the leading and trailing edge of the plate. And here you see the both internal waves and wake, what is this in the wake, which coexist in this situation. And when the velocity of movement, of plate movement, is quite big, we see only the intensive vortices which develop downstream. Very practically valuable situation when we have significantly great velocity of movement of the plate. And we consider two different fluid types, a strongly stratified fluid and potentially homogeneous fluid. Its velocity Reynolds number up to 10 in 5 degree. It's no time, yes? So in this situation, we have an intensive vortices which are produced by the leading edge of the plate, and I can show you what happens. The vortices are developed downstream from the upper and lower sides of the plate. Then they meet in around the trailing edge of the plate. But the situation is very different when the thickness of the plate is another less than in this case there are no in this case there are no vortices which appear in the around the leading edge and also only in the wake. And when in angle of inclination is 5 degree, we see that there is no almost no vortices appear around along the lower surface of the plate, and the structure of the vortices the scale of the vortices get greater with further increase of angle inclination. The structure of vortex structure is became multi-scale, and there are more differences between flow structures in a strongly stratified and potentially homogeneous fluid. Here you see some. So it's a different location. Okay. Comparison with the Blasius solution, we see that when the plate is quite thick, there is no agreement with Blasius solution. But when we take a thinner plate, we have a good agreement. But away from the edges. So there is my conclusion. There is no time to take. So thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much. The speaker.
Yes, diffusion velocities of diffusion induced flows is very slow. Yes, it's about 5 minus 5 degree. Yes.